For exercise 2, the customer would like to have a way to visualize their downtime events for each of their turbines. We're going to do that by creating a new display that has an event frame table to show all of these event frames. Let's get started by creating a new display. First, we can create some symbols on the display to show the turbine name and the status. To do that, we can select any turbine. I will select NY001, and then find the turbine name attribute. Now I can format this just to show the value like before. And I can increase the font size to make it stand out. Now, also on the turbine element, I can scroll down and find an attribute that shows the status of the turbine. I'll again use the value symbol and add this in my display. We can see this turbine currently has a status of run, which means it's running. Now I can format this to maybe not show the label since I have the turbine right next to it. Now that I have my turbine, let's see if we can visualize any event frames that have happened on it. To do that, we can go to the Events pane over on the left, and we can tick the box to automatically refresh the list. What this will do is show us any event frames for the assets on the display in the time range of the display. So in this case, we're looking for any event frames on turbine NY001 that have happened in the past 8 hours. To create a table of these event frames, we can use the Create Events Table button. In the Configure Table pane, we can see what table columns we're able to show. If we would like to show the duration of the event frame, we can also check that box. Now, let's just format our display to move this more underneath the attribute showing the name and the status. And let's save our display and call it Wind Farm Turbine Detail _ our initials. Now that our display has been created, let's go through the questions. The first question asks, when was the last time turbine PH002 in Philadelphia had a downtime event? So to visualize that, we're going to need to change the context of this display from NY001 to PH002. To do that, we can just use the asset drop-down box. Once you change the asset, you should notice the event frame table updates to show event frames from turbine PH002. Now we can answer, when was the last time turbine PH002 in Philadelphia had a downtime event? Looks like the answer to that question is at 2:40 p.m. The next question is, what is the approximate peak lost revenue rate in that time range? So to see more information about this event frame, we can click on it to show event details. In the event details screen, we can see all of the attributes associated with that event frame. If we scroll down, we can find the lost revenue rate attribute. And if we click the trend icon, we can trend it in this display area here. Now we can see that the peak lost revenue rate is between $115 and $120 per kilowatt hour. It also asks, what is the approximate minimum apparent power for that time range? Again, we can find that attribute and click the trend icon to show it on the trend. The minimum for this attribute seems to be between 2200 and 2225 kilowatts. If you're looking to get a more accurate representation of those numbers, we could perhaps do something with our display itself. Let's go back into the Assets pane and let's make a table that shows both the lost revenue rate and apparent power attributes. Before doing that, we'll change back to Turbine NY001 to keep all of our new symbols the same as the existing ones. You notice in the trend, we have columns that show the minimum and maximum. The only issue is this is going to be showing the minimum and maximum for the display time range, which is the last 8 hours. We would like now to change this time range just to show the time range that corresponds to that event frame. To do that, we can right-click on that event in the event table and hit Apply Time Range. Now, we can get a more accurate representation of what the minimum and maximums were for those attributes in that time range.